Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys about buttons in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Buttons. You click them, and then they do stuff. That's pretty much it. So before we begin, make sure you have this import at the top. So first we'll begin by creating a window so we can add this button to the window. So we'll create an instance of a window called window equals tk parentheses, and then we'll need to display this window by typing in window.mainloop. So this will create a window for us. However, we'll create a button next to add to this window. So let me think of a descriptive name for this button. Maybe something unique like button. So button equals button, parentheses, and then we're going to list the component that we're adding this button to. We're adding this button to our window, and then let's also set some text. So the text equals maybe click me. Let's make this a very aggressive button by adding some exclamation points. And then we're going to pack this button so we can add this button to the window. So button.pack. And let's try it. Here's our button. It says click me, but when you click it, it doesn't do anything. So we can link this button to a function in our program. So we use the command property. So button.config. And then we're going to say command equals and then a function name. But first we'll need to create a function. So let's define a function. Maybe I'll call this click. And what do we want to do when we call this function? Let's say we want to print hello. That's good enough. So with command, we're going to set this equal to the function name. Make sure you do not include the parentheses. So make sure you don't write this, but this. So that's the proper way to do this. So what this does is that it performs callback of function. And let's try this. Here's our button. When we click this button, it displays hello. Cool. Let's customize this button. So let's change the font. So button.config. And I'm going to copy this because we'll be using this quite often. Font equals, let's say ink free for the font style. And then a size, maybe 50. And I'll make this bold. It's a very aggressive button. Let's change the background color. So button.config, BG for background color. And we can place a hexadecimal value here. So let's pick a color. It's an aggressive button, so let's do something like an orangish red color. That'll work. So I'm going to copy that, place this value here. There we are. Let's also change the font color. So button.config, this time it is FG for foreground color. And for this color, maybe a bright neon yellow of some sort. So copy this value, paste it here, and the font of the text should change. Now, when we click this button, it's white and black, so we'll want to change that too. So there's different properties for those, active background and active foreground. So let's change those next. So button.config. And first we'll change active background equals another value. So I'll just pick red, that is FF0000. So when we click this button, the background should now be red. I think I'll change the font color after we click the button too, because the default is black. So this is active foreground, and I will set it to be the same as our base foreground, so it's this number. There we go. So the text is staying the same color, but the background is changing. Now, instead of some text, let's add an image here instead. So I have one image that's within my main folder this time. So first we'll create a photo image. So I will call this image equals photo image file equals, and then the file path. So since this file of mine, it's called pointemoji.png, it's within my main folder, the same place where my Python file is located. I can just list the file name here. So that is point_emoji.png. And then we're going to take button.config, and this image is going to be set to whatever the name of our image is, which is also image. And let's run this. So here is the picture that I have. It's called point_emoji.png, and it does the exact same thing. However, it replaced the text with the image that we listed. If you need to display text as well as an image on your button, what you could do is use the compound property. So button.config compound. And we can set this to top, bottom, left, or right, or none. So let's try top. So this places our picture on the top and the text on the bottom. And we can reverse that with bottom. Left. Right. And this is none. Which is what we had before, basically. However, I believe I'm going to set this to bottom. Alright, well, up next, let me teach you guys how we can disable a button. So button.config state equals either active or disabled. So if this is set to disabled, we can no longer click this button. It doesn't do anything. So this disables button, and it's either active or disabled. But I'm just going to turn this whole line of code into a comment because we still have work to do on this. Okay guys, it's project time. So we're going to create a project that's going to display how many times we have clicked this button since we ran it. So instead of printing the word hello, let's display a variable such as count. But first we'll need to declare this. So count, and we'll set this equal to 0 to begin. And then we're going to make count a global variable. So within our function click, we're going to say global count. And then after we click this button, we're going to increment count by 1. So count plus equals 1. And then let's just print count for now, just to be sure that this is working. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Cool, that's working then. So now instead of displaying our count variable in our console window, let's actually display this on our window. So we're going to create a label to do this for us. So I'm going to call this label. Label equals label. We're adding this to our window. And then we're going to set the text to equal count. And then we're going to pack this label. So label.pack. So it's up here. You can't really see it though. So let's change the font. So label.config font equals, and I think I'll pick monospace, and 50 for the size. Okay, it's up here. However, the label doesn't change, so we're going to work on that next. So within the function, instead of print, we're going to add label.config text equals count. And then that is pretty much it. So let's try it again. One, two, three. All right. You can also display a picture too. Why don't we create a second label? So we'll do that here. We'll call this label 2 equals label. And we're adding this window or this label to our window. And let's set the image to equal our point emoji image again. We're just going to reuse this. So what we're going to do after we click the button and we call this click function, we're going to pack label 2. Label2.pack. So now when we click this button, it's also going to display an image for us. So that's your introduction to buttons in Python. If you'd like a copy of all this code, I'll post everything in the comments down below. But yeah, that's an introduction to buttons in Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.